When building a log cabin, you need many tools, and we have a lot of those here at the Historical Society. The tools included everything from a buck saw that would be used to cut down the tree and especially clean up the log ends, hooks that would be used to move or drag the logs around, a draw knife that would be used to remove the bark and smooth the outer surface, but it's the broad axe and the adze that were used to square the logs that I want to focus in on today. If you look at the log cabin, it's actually one of the best places to see these marks. You just need to look up. You can see that the undersides of the upper floor, the logs are square or rectangle, and you can see actually the hatch marks, the perpendicular marks that were on the logs themselves. They would have been made with a broad axe, a force down. So what they would have done is they would have put the log on the ground. They would have made perpendicular marks, as you can see on the log, and then they would have turned that log on the side and sort of like cutting bread or something like that, chipped off the bulk of the log that they would have used to square it up. But that wouldn't have been smooth enough. It was that they would have then rolled back so that the now flatter surface is facing up. They would have rolled that back facing up, straddled the log, and then taking the long-handled adze, as you can see, that we have in Harvest and Heritage Hall, they would have taken that and swinging that between their legs, they would have used that to smooth the surface of the log. Probably some injury did happen, but a good logsman, a good house builder would have become very careful about doing that sort of thing. You can certainly again see those logs when you look up, but you can also see them on the interior of the cabin. Although the places where the logs meet still are curved, they've squared off the logs on the inside to provide a little more livable space and using surface. And you can see those perpendicular marks made initially by the broad axe and then smoothed by the adze.